This is the prettiest way to find the sum of the series of n is equal to. This is the prettiest way to find the sum of the series as n goes from 1 to infinity of n over 2 to the n. But before we do anything, we shall see if this right here converges or not. It does converge, and converges by the Rachel test. So let me just mention that I'm not going to do it because I will actually just show you guys how to find the sum. All right, this here, it's almost like a geometric series, but because we have the n right here, so it's not geometric, but it's okay. Check this out. I'm just going to expand it. So the first term is going to be plugging 1. We get 1 over 2 to the first power, which is just 2. Next, plugging 2. So we get 2 over 2 to the second, which is 4. And then the next term is 3 over 2 to the third. And then 4 over 2 to the fourth, which is 16. And keeps on going forever. You see, because we have the 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on the top, this is not geometric. But check this out. If we do write down the first term, which is 1 half, and if we look at 2 over 4 as 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4, aha! Break this down and we see if we have 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4. Next one we have 3 over 8, so I'm going to break this down. We will get 1 over 8 plus 1 over 8, and then plus 1 over 8. And then right here we have 4, right? So of course, plus 1 over 16, plus 1 over 16, and then plus 1 over 16, and then one more plus 1 over 16. Aha! You see that for this row, in fact, it keeps on going forever. Likewise for this row, and then likewise for this row, and then likewise for this row. And if you look at each every row, they are all what? Geometric series. But how many rows do we have? Infinitely many. So right here, I'm just going to put down plus, because it keeps on going horizontally and also vertically, so I will put down plus dot, 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 like so, diagonally. Okay, so this right here, right, is equal to that. And for this row, we know it's just going to be the convergent geometric series because the common ratio is just 1 half, which converges to the first term, which is 1 over 2 here, and then divided by 1 minus the common ratio, which is 1 over 2. And work that out, we will just get 1. Next, this is the common ratio, which is 1, this is the first term, and then divided by 1 minus the same common ratio, and of course, this is just half of the previous, which is just going to give us 1 over 2. And then, of course, 1 over 8 over 1 minus 1 over 2, and we'll get 1 over 4, and then just keep on going. And we have the 1 over 16. In fact, this is a pretty nice technique. 1 over 8, all right? And then, of course, you can see that this right here just dot, 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 and then, of course, dot, dot, dot. And, of course, we just have to add up everybody, so add, 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 add 1 plus 1 half plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 8. Oh my goodness, what is this? Yes, this right here is the geometric series again. So in fact, that's pretty much like a double, I don't know how you call it, infinitely many geometric series of geometric series, somewhat like that. But anyway, in the end, this right here converges to the first term, which is going to be 1, and then over 1 minus the common ratio, which is 1 over 2. So the answer is 1 minus 1 half, which is 2. Aha! So all this right here is just equal to 2. Very nice. I do have some other videos with similar flavor, so go ahead and check them out.